All right, Trauma, big shout out to Ivan Chu for bringing us some absolutely incredible customs. I am very happy to be talking about this today because I do want to make the announcement that on my channel, as you guys have seen before, I will be accepting coverage of any of your guys' customs. So if you guys are working on a project right now that you wanted to maybe have displayed on a news channel, I'd be more than happy to do it on my channel here and covering it. So maybe there's something that you want to make an announcement, you're not sure exactly where you want to start, I'd be more than happy to cover it here, post it on anything that I have. You know, you guys already know that I'm on Facebook, so this is where I get a lot of my content from. But again, you can send me stuff directly and I will cover it on my page. I want to make sure that everybody who's in the 118 community has an opportunity to shine with what they're working on and to let other people know, obviously, of other projects that they would most likely be interested in. All right, you guys, so let's go ahead and break it down. All right, you guys, so starting off these beautiful customs from Ivan Chu, we're going to have Mass Effect Andromeda character. So on the right, we do have what is obviously Shepard, and on the left, we do have just another character. If you've played the games, which I haven't played in such a long time, and I definitely haven't played Andromeda, I don't know who this is depicting, but if you do know, please let me know in the comment section. But as you can tell, these look awesome. So here's my question for you guys. Would you guys want to see Joy Toy, Acid Rain, or just anybody take over a 1/18th scale of these kinds of figures of the Mass Effect line? As you can tell, these are really nicely done, and you could definitely see the basis for, you know, a lot more of these coming out. And I do love characters like Rex, the Krogans, the, you know, I remember in Mass Effect 2, they had like 3 different factions. And if they were to make those factions, right, the guys in the yellow armor, blue armor, and red armor, that would be absolutely magnificent. Now, if you thought that these were just armored figures, you are absolutely wrong. Ivan went the extra step and actually made heads for them, and as you can tell, they look pretty great. This gives them that extra level of realism that I think really takes this to the top, so I really enjoy what I'm seeing here. Here we have the female character by herself, and she does have a pistol. Now, if I'm correct, these pistols and these guns are fairly accurate to the source material. And obviously so is the entire look that we're getting here, so I am liking what I'm seeing and I would love to see more of these. Now, you can see here that this has to be from the Battle of the Stars, the, I forget what exactly they're called, but they're the red skin warriors with the red armor. This is basically the base from that, at least that's what I'm getting. I could be wrong, but that's sort of what I'm seeing here. Now, this here, also from Ivan, was another character from the same line of basically Mass Effect troops. As you can tell, this is basically a Spartan underbody with a Spartan gun, but it is supposed to be from Mass Effect. I do like overall the coloring that we get here, and of course the custom head that goes with it. I think this is a really dope piece, and again, this just exemplifies all of the many options that Mass Effect really did offer us. I'd like to point out here that this one is, I want to say, even bigger than the Shepard one. I don't think I have any photos of them together, but it's really nice to see a variety in size. Again, this exemplifies, you know, all the different creatures that were in Mass Effect, all the different soldiers, all the different armor types. There's a lot that they could do here if somebody were to pick this up, maybe even reach out to Ivan and put him on, basically put him on to help, you know, make this come true. Now, if you thought it was going to stop there, no, no, no. This boy is really kicking ass here. So we have here a Wonder Woman. I don't think I've ever seen specifically this armor type, but I don't care. It's a really phenomenal look. I really... Oh, truck coming by. Give me 1 second. Okay. But yes, this is really nice. Comes equipped with everything you see here. The shield, the sword, the base with the Wonder Woman insignia on it. This is a really badass rendition of Wonder Woman. And as you can see here, that head sculpt looks really close to Gal Gadot. You know, this is obviously a 1/18th scale, so there's only so much you can do with that, but I think this is a really clear rendition of that character, and this is a really good look. I really like that a lot of people are starting to get into this. Joel was one of the people that I believe that I might end up getting, you know, a little special order done. I'm not going to tell you guys about it until I have it in hand, but just know it is somewhere in the works. Now, this right here is a nice touch. The base that he made, I believe, can hold the blade and the shield as you see it, and that's really nice. You know, if you want to put the character off in a fight somewhere and you want to store everything, you can do that. And I wouldn't be surprised if there's a way to just store it all on the base just the way you see it, with Wonder Woman in the back maybe standing on it. So that's really tight. Now, staying in with DC, he even also made a Two-Face. Damn! And this is Two-Face, I believe, from the movie. And this is one of my favorite movies, The Dark Knight, with Heath Ledger. his version of Joker, and it would be absolutely incredible. Ivan, if you are reading this, it would be absolutely dope for you. Excuse me, listening to this, it'd be absolutely dope for you to make like a Heath Ledger Joker. That might be something that I'd be interested in getting, just to commemorate that character. You know, rest in peace, Heath Ledger. And here we have a little bit more of a direct shot of what it looks like. And yeah, that's impressive. That right side of the face does look absolutely mauled. And then the left side looks absolutely normal. This is a good rendition of a 1/18 scale Two-Face. And almost like if he knows exactly what I'm into, Ivan also did The Last Samurai. Now this right here is Katsumoto. As you know, he was basically the second main character to Algren's character, basically the leader of the last group of samurai. And this looks absolutely stunning. This one right here is by far the most impressive one. And this begs the question, right? I know that 1/18 scale for DC, we already have that kind of stuff, but would you want to see some 1/18 scale The Last Samurai stuff? There are multiple characters, multiple samurais. They are armored, unarmored, Bowman. There's a lot of different characters that they could pull from, and I would absolutely buy each and every single one of them to make my Last Samurai diorama, including one of, you know, Algren in the red armor. I think that that would be magnificent. And if they could also, you know, maybe even give us, you know, those World War One, or not even World War One, you know, modernized Japan soldiers as well to fight them, that would be incredible. But again, this is Ivan's work, and it's just magnificent. I can't tell what base body he used to do this, but it looks great. And then here we have obviously the head that he was painting together, and oh my god, this head is absolutely incredible. That looks identical to what we got in the movie, down to the shading of the head, because remember, he does have a bald head, but he does have a little bit of a 5 o'clock shadow on the top of his head, and this just looks great. This is definitely something that I would be interested for a company to start doing in mass, so again, I can get all the characters, but only if they can have it at this quality, because this quality is quite impeccable. Now, correct me if I'm wrong as you switch over to the Acid Rain world, but I believe this is by Daniel Gogueta. Let me know if I'm incorrect here, because I was trying to find the original post about this, but you know, I know some of you are on the same Facebook page as me and you've seen this before, so by all means, please correct me so I'm giving the right person what they need in terms of credit for what they do. But this is basically the Strongholds tank treads replacement. A lot of the stuff from Acid Rain, especially the older Oritoi stuff, doesn't necessarily run across the ground all that well due to the kind of material that they use, so there have been some replacements made for the treads on this Stronghold tank. Now, I do believe this is the new treads already basically put onto the tank itself. It does look pretty good. I don't have this in person. I've never tried this before. I couldn't tell you for sure this fixes any of the issues when it comes to it being able to roll around, but I wouldn't be surprised if it does work phenomenally well. Obviously, this is an upgrade, and as I mentioned, the material isn't the best with what it comes with stock, but this upgrade might be worth it to you. And as you'll see right here, this is how you know that I do my shit absolutely live. So what we were looking at before is actually the old treads. I believe this is the new treads. And I want to say that makes a lot of sense. This obviously is multiple pieces put together to create this chain link that runs through it. And this definitely looks more like something that would actually be able to move with more ease. So I do appreciate that there are still stuff coming out for older Acid Rain stuff, because who knows? That means we could get older stuff for the Omega, for, you know, other factions. That would be really nice, because I still have the MK2, MK7, I forget what it is, but it's the one that transforms and it has the gun cannon arms, but it looks like a speeder car with a single cockpit. And this is how it's going to be basically packaged. So you'll get a baggie like this. I'm sure right there in the background, we see how to put them onto the new one. 85 individual plastic pieces. So please be careful if you do end up buying this. Literally, you lose one and that's the entire tread. I'll admit, while I've never bought this tank before, seeing it with the new treads, it is definitely at least a visual upgrade. This definitely looks a lot better, a lot more realistic. This definitely takes this up to another level. And again, that's what I'm saying. I love to be able to see custom works. That's honestly really dope. Now, while we're still on the topic of custom, so basically the Marauders, the Vietnam stuff, I guess they were getting some feedback from a lot of the people who are backing the Kickstarter. And this is where I have to give props. I guess people were saying that they wanted a little bit more variety with the with the sleeves. And so if you guys know that I've shown you this before, the sleeves came down below the joint that you see there, basically right at the elbows. So there was no skin above that. Well, apparently they've decided to go ahead and make a couple adjustments and bring the sleeves actually even a little higher above the elbows to give it a slightly different look. So guys, this is exactly what the community needs. I think that all JoyToy, like especially right now that we're getting a lot of their stuff pre-production, when they're still literally on a screen in front of the actual creators where they can go ahead and do something differently, I think this is exactly what we need, where, you know, a toy maker, while it's still in the process of making something, while it can still make the changes without it costing them much, they should be asking the community what they want. And, you know, especially for people who are on Kickstarter, but even people who are just pre-ordering, it would be lovely for companies to say, hey, look, this is our solicitation. This is still it on screen. Is there anything you guys would want a little bit more? Because it costs them, you know, next to nothing to make those small little changes that potentially are possible. I'm not saying they're going to be able to make every change the community wants, but it'd be absolutely nice to be able to at least get part of that so that we can go ahead and get the finished product. There are things that I'm not going to probably buy because there are in the future, you know, a company is going to miss the mark on something. But had they just talked to the community, maybe reached out to myself so I can post it for you guys and get feedback directly from you guys, like, that would be awesome. So if there are any toy makers who are watching this right now, you know, by all means, you know, 1/18 scale stuff, by all means, I'd be willing to share it with the community in order for you to get the feedback you need so that we as a community can buy the figures that we actually want. And what's really cool about the photos that you guys have seen so far, by the way, is that now we're actually seeing the guns. So we have a few that we've gotten. Here's the AK-47. I think it's going to be a really nice look in hand. And I do hope these guys have enough articulation to be able to look downside with ease. Right here, we do have the Swedish K machine gun. It's a pretty looking gun, I'm not gonna lie. This guy's gonna look absolutely badass with this one. And then for this last one, we get a very similar look again. And then again, the Swedish K machine gun. I'm not sure, I don't remember ever using this gun in any game that I ever played that involved Vietnam. But if they existed and they're real, by all means, I would definitely want to get my hands on that. That looks like, a dope machine gun. And then again, I do commend Marauder for making slight adjustments to, again, give us the figures that we want as a community.